everyone, welcome to my channel Healthy with Aparna. Today I am going to talk about infertility and hormonal imbalance. Everything starts with endocrine system, which is made up of endocrine glands that secretes hormones. Hormones are chemicals that are produced by glands in the endocrine system. Now the system helps control mood, growth, development and the way our organs work, our metabolism, immunity and reproduction. We have millions of cells in our body and endocrine system helps them to communicate with each other. And when there is a miscommunication, it leads to hormonal imbalance. The endocrine system regulates how much each hormone is released. And when this system don't function properly, it results in hormonal imbalance. If they don't communicate well, they adversely affect reproductive health by mimicking or blocking the effects of sex hormones as well as fertility. Now, because of this hormonal imbalance, it results in infertility, low AMH level, poor egg and sperm quality, irregular periods, dark brown discharge before or during the periods, enlarged ovaries, PCOS, PCOD, and many more. And because of hormonal imbalance, problem not only restrict to infertility, but in long run, it also results in thyroid, heart disease, leaky gut, IBS, emotional imbalance, and many more. So what are the most common reasons for hormonal imbalance, infertility, and so many health problems? Poor eating habits, for example, eating sugary, packed, processed food with low nutritional value, sedentary lifestyle, not being active throughout the day, or who are in desk jobs. Third, chronic stress, long-term stress, poor sleep quality, all these result into chronic stress. So these are the three main common problems which results in hormonal imbalance. Generally, pills medicine treats the problem or the symptoms, not the root cause. Although for some people medicine is needed, but with that you need to work on lifestyle changes. Just adding a pill will not help you to improve your condition. Improve your eating habits, add food rich in good fats such as nuts, ghee, coconut oil, fish, paneer. Try to add protein in every meal. For example, eggs are a rich source of protein, pumpkin seeds, paneer, soya. Now vitamin D, it is very important. It improves ovarian stimulation and semen quality. The most common source of vitamin D is sunshine. Daily 10 to 15 minutes of sunshine is good. Apart from that, good source of vitamin D in foods are eggs and mushroom. Vitamin A, it improves fertility. Good sources are carrots, eggs, orange and yellow vegetables and fruits. Vitamin B12, which are rich in grains, eggs, fish, milk. Now folic acid is an important vitamin for both men and women. Getting enough folic acids can help to decrease the risk of birth defects and also improves sperm count in men. And it's good for people who are planning for embryo transfer also. Green leafy vegetables, lentils, broccoli, fortified cereals, oranges, these are some good sources of folic acid. Add vitamin C. It supports sperm count mobility and also works on immunity. Citrus food, bell pepper, tomatoes, broccoli are some of the good source of vitamin C. Apart from adding all this, it's very important that we add anti-inflammatory or foods which are rich in antioxidants, such as berries, turmeric, saffron, black pepper. Will a particular food cure your infertility? No, that's not going to happen. But that shouldn't stop you from considering the so-called fertility superfoods to make sure you are getting proper nutrition to support your fertility. Overall, good nutrition leads to good health, and good overall health will balance your hormones and protect your fertility. Superfoods such as pumpkin seeds and flax seeds are good source of fats which help in balancing progesterone and estrogen level. Pumpkin seeds provide zinc which helps in balance out progesterone. Apart from that, green leafy vegetables and fruits are a rich source of many vitamins. If you are showing signs of estrogen deficiency, adding chickpeas is a good idea, as they are rich, high sources of natural estrogen, which can help to create hormonal balance for optimal fertility. Now, there are a few things which you can avoid to start working on your hormonal imbalance from today onwards. Avoid refined sugar and sugary drinks, soft drinks. Avoid processed food or canned food. Hydrate well. Always track your water intake. Water helps nutrient absorption and removing toxin from our body. Practice deep breathing. For example, if you are under stress and you take a pill, immediately you will not see any results. It takes time. But for example, if you are under stress, your cortisol level is high. You practice deep breathing. Just stop doing everything and practice deep breathing, and your cortisol level will start coming down immediately. Instantly, you will see that you feel better and you are able to handle the situation better. Stay healthy, stay happy. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel for regular updates.